Hello, welcome. I'm here to remind you to make sure you have backups of your important data and to show you a very nice open source tool that can help you with it. It's been called the Holy Grail of Backups by a famous Greek open source contributor and also author. Next slide, please. So here's an overview of the features. So basically, it's a command line tool. It does everything you would expect of a backup. So the main job is to do like point in time snapshots of your data. So you can always go back to like a previous time, like last week, if you delete something by accident, or if you lose everything. And it's doing deduplication, so you can move stuff around or have stuff multiple times and it still won't use more data. It also does compression. It integrates the latest Facebook compression algorithm, so that makes it very efficient. And when you want to browse your backups, you can mount it as a virtual drive and you can look through all the snapshots, which is very nice. Next slide, please. So backup, of course, you need some backup space to host your backup on, so there are multiple options to this. You can have your own SSH server that has Borg installed on the client and the server and you back it up there. Or if you don't want to run your own server, there are a couple of commercial services. The two older ones are rsync.net and Hetzner, which offer you Borg as part of their like SSH storage space. Then there's, since last year, there's Borgbase, which is my project. It's like custom made for Borg, and it does some extended stuff like monitoring and append only security, so the client can never change your old backups. And you can also ask your friends or use a local hard drive. Next slide, please. Then last year, there were also some interesting new wrappers around or some projects around Borg. So another project of mine is Vorta, which is a user interface for Borg. So you can have a nice desktop client and you can make your backups through this. And for servers, you also have Borgmatic, which is a wrapper that takes care of all your Borg configurations because those can get very complex. And this wraps it for you. Next slide, please. So this is the main user interface of Vorta. So you have a little client running in your system tray. You can choose, you can have multiple profiles, multiple repositories, and you can choose the compression level. Next slide, please. Then you can choose the folders you want to back up, and you can have some exclusions. Next slide, please. So this is an overview of all the backups you have, like the point-in-time archives. Next slide, please. And when you want to browse or restore files, you can browse it as a tree. Next slide, please. And you have a flexible schedule. Next slide. And you can, for example, we as the open source community is still like thinking about features, and one of them is like to choose which Wi-Fi you want to use for backups. Maybe you don't want to use your phone. Next slide, please. So it's fully open source. It's built in Python, in modern Python version, like Python 3. Then there's also some Cython and C code in it, and we're building single file binaries for easy deployment, so you don't have to install Python at all. You can just download the full binary and run it directly. Next slide, please. This we can stick. Next slide, please. And what we are looking for, we're looking for developers, of course. We're looking for people who test it. We're looking for people who have ideas for features, who want to write documentation, and also for security reviewers, anyone who knows something about encryption, to improve the encryption. And also, if you're using it for your company, you can always make a donation via bounty source, and it goes into GitHub issues. Next slide. Okay, there are the links, and you can check it out on github.com borg backup or github.com borgbase. Thank you.
Thank you very much. I will point out the